The Mughal Empire was an imperial power which ruled most of the India and Pakistan from the 16th to the 17th centuries. The Great Mughals, as they're sometimes called, changed the face of India with their political, military, and artistic achievements.
Zahiruddin Muhammad Babur was the founder of the Mughal Empire in India.
He was of noble blood. On his father's side, he was a Timurid, a Persian Turk, known as Amir Taimur Birlas. And on his mother's side, he was a descendant of Genghis Khan.
In 1556, the greatest of the Mughal emperors and an extremely capable ruler, Jalaluddin Muhammad Akbar, succeeded his father Humayun. He extended his power and influence over the entire country. He led conquests that greatly expanded his rule. He established and consolidated the Mughal Empire.
Ba Adab, Ba Mulayda, Hoshyar, Hazrat Jalaluddin Muhammad Akbar Tashreef La Rahe Hain.
My name is Jalaluddin Muhammad Akbar. I was born on October 15, 1542. At the tender age of 13, I became the ruler of the Mughal Empire. Because of my accomplishments, I am also known as Akbar the Great.
My name is Birbal, and I, along with other learned men like Mia Tan Singh, Abul Fazl, Faizi Raja Man Singh, Raja Tolar Mal, Mulla Gupyaza, Fakir Azizuddin, and Abdul Rahim Khan, were called Nine Gems of Akbar.
And Jalaluddin Akbar dedicated his first decade of his rule towards expanding his empire. Ajmer, Malwa, Gondwana, Rajputana, Khadakatanga, and many more states were added to the Mughal territories.
The emperor himself was the supreme governor of empire. He also appointed wazir like me to look after revenue and finance.
Hello, I am Amir Bakshi. I am the head of military, appointed from among the leading nobles of the court.
I am known as Mir Saman or Khanai Saman, and my duty is to look after royal buildings, stores, workshops, roads, and parks. I am in charge of imperial household.
I am the chief Qazi, also known as the Sadr. I am the head of religious donations and contributions.
Agriculture production was at the center of the Mughal economy. Farmers grew and exported large quantities of highly valued commodities such as tobacco, cotton, sugarcane, pepper, ginger, and even silk.
Mughal rulers brought in revenue by taxing these goods. Farmers and villages paid taxes on their goods with silver or copper coin. The Mughal economic growth boomed, and the economic gain to be worth hundreds of millions of rupees per year.
I am a farmer from Mughal era. Agriculture is the main productive activity, as the soil is fertile in most parts of India, and people are known here for their knowledge of agriculture operations.
Farmers pay a special type of tax called jizya in exchange for protection in their life and property.
Inland and coastal trade flourished during that era. Some of the most common products exchanged were textiles, spices, precious metals, carpet, and horses.
The Mughal period marked a striking revival of Islamic architecture in the subcontinent. The architecture is a remarkably symmetrical and decorative combination of Persian, Turkish, and Indian architecture.
A lot of majestic red sandstone structures were built during my era, like the Lahore Fort, Bachai Mosque, and Shalimar Gardens.
My name is Shah Jahan. Just like my grandfather Akbar, I was fond of architecture. I am well known for building Taj Mahal out of white marble.
The Mughals left a permanent mark on society, culture, and art. Islamic calligraphy flourished in Mughal courts.
As a calligrapher, my job is to decorate every new building with calligrapher panels. The emperor appoints only me for the translation of official businesses.
The Mughal paintings in the miniature shell teach us about the clothing and lifestyle of the people. The golden era of Kathak is considered to have begun under the third, perhaps the greatest ruler of the Mughal dynasty, Akbar the Great.
I use my footwork, spins, intricate rhythm, displays and angular movement while performing the Kathak dance. Let me show you how it's done.
For hosting musical and dance performances in my courts.
Bacha Salamat, Turki se chand mehman aapki khidmat mein mehfile mausiqi sajane ki ijazat chahte hain.
Ijazat hai.
British influenced.
By the middle of the 1700s, the Mughal ruled only a small area around the city of Delhi.
The last Mughal emperor was Bahadur Shah II. The British allowed him to reign until 1857. Then they forced him to leave India.